بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Inherently, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this insan with the quality of following Allah. Fitrah. Naturally, we should be inclined to obey Allah. Kullu mawludin yuladu ala al-fitrah. Every child, every birth, everyone born is inherently born with this fitrah. The temperament, the mizaj, the mindset to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But due to the environment and taking effect on the environment, otherwise, أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ In the Alam Arwah, everybody accepted 100% that Allah is the creator. But he came into dunya in the womb of the mother, where there was no space or light, this insan was manufactured. Whereas a factory requires space for manufacturing, it needs light for manufacturing, it needs a lot of raw materials for manufacturing, etc., etc., etc. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this insan in the womb of the mother. So many signs, so many ayat, but because of the da'wah, and the invitation of dunya, we are seeing dunya, we are listening to dunya, we are speaking about dunya, we are thinking about dunya, man has become overpowered. We need to start speaking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, speaking about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So first thing was we need to make a dua. فَإِنَّ أَحَدًا لَمْ يُطَى بَعْدَ الْيَقِينِ خَيْرًا مِنَ الْعَافِيَةِ That after yaqeen, the first thing you need to make dua for is yaqeen, that Allah give me this correct yaqeen. The best dua after yaqeen is afiyah. So we see even in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned different incidents of different nations. And when each nation reached the climax and the peak of invention was their downfall, because that invention, that technology, that power, that strength, that intellect, that wealth, that profession, that artistry, that skill that they had, they reached such a limit where they made dawah of uluhiyah. La ilaha illallah. The word Allah is one who you are bewildered and you are astonished. You forget everything else. That is how powerful the Zat of Allah is. That when we remember Allah, we forget everything else. So each nation was destroyed when they reached the climax of the inventions, because the Yaqeen went on to Asbab and it never went to Khaliq Asbab. We met one scholar, Maulana Shihabuddin, while we were 1 year in India, in Hyderabad. And he had spent time in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He came to South Africa. He was with Colonel Amiruddin as well. And he gave us an incident of how he came to South Africa. There were two of them in Jama'at. And when they left Nizamuddin Markaz, Hazrat Ji Maulana Imam Al-Hasan rahmatullahi gave them one advice, hidayat. And he says, Tum behrun ja raha hai andarun banane ke liye. You are going outside this country, you're going overseas, you're going international to make your insides. You're going outside to make your insides. Anyway, you were saying that Maulana Yusmali came and in the Markaz in Hyderabad, Maulana gave a bayan. And he said, one sentence that I heard from Maulana Yusuf Rahmatullah Alayhi prompted me, motivated me to go out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately for 1 year. I realized that this is a deficiency in me and I need to make effort until this comes into my life. Maulana said, Jo is asbab-e dunya mein, musabbibul asbab se lena nahi sika hai. To kya umeed hai, kabar ki zindagi, jaha koi azbab nahi hai, woh musabbibul azbab se kis tarah le sakte. That person enjoys asbab-e-dunya, in this world which is filled with asbabs, asbab and means, and different systems which man follows. So this is a world of systems. Musabbibul asbab se lena nahi sikha hai. He has not learned to take from the one that is in control of all asbab, in control of all means. So what hope can this person have that after having all the asbab and all the means at his disposal, what hope can you have if you cannot take from a world which is based on asbab, from the one who is controlling asbab? To kya umeed hai qabr ki zindagi, that when you are in the qabr, where there will be no asbab, there will be no means at all, how will you take from musabibul asbab? He said, I realized I'm not taking from my Khaliq, from my Razik, from my Malik, from my Allah. And he went out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after spending his time, he came back to Maulana Yusuf Maulana and said, Maulana, I still don't think so. I've learned the lesson of Iman. I don't think so. I've learned the lesson of taking from the khazana and the treasures of Allah. So Maulana said, this is a lifetime effort. Now go back home and carry on making effort on this Iman. Carry on making effort on Allah. So this effort of Iman, we need to be making from the cradle to the grave. Salat, Maulana Yusuf used to say, ke jiske namaz mein do roti milne ka yakin nahi hai, to is namaz se kis tarah jannat mil sakti. That a person is reading Salat his entire life, yet through the Salat, he cannot even get one or two pieces of bread. How does he expect that through the Salat he will get Jannah? If a person's Iman is so weak, it cannot take him from his bed to the Masjid. How does he expect his Iman to take him from this dunya to Qabr, to Hashar, to pull sirat, through mizan, through all the stages of akhirat and save him from Jahannam and get him into Jannah, when his Iman is so weak, it can't even get him out of his bed? A sahabi is traveling, his donkey dies, he reaches to rakat salat. Allah gives the donkey life. Sahaba had yaqeen in amal, they had yaqeen in the zaat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody was in itikaf, somebody passed and asked him, you're sitting here in itikaf like people down look upon people who are doing good and all these fine excuses. He said, how are you surviving? How are you, what are you doing? You're all the time in itikaf. So the person said, outside the masjid, there's a Jewish shop. And every meal he gives me two pieces of bread. So the person said, oh, very good, very good. So he said, I told you that a non-Muslim is giving me two pieces of bread and you are consoled by that answer, but you are not ready to accept it. Allah, who is the creator of the entire creation, is feeding us. You're not ready to accept that. People generally stay around the masjid. So they give charity, they give donations, they give to the masjid. And people are saying that alhamdulillah, the masjid is surviving because of us. Alhamdulillah, we pay the light, we pay the water, we pay the electricity. The masjid is surviving because of us. Little do you know that the masjid is not surviving because of you and your sitqah and your charity, but you are surviving because of the masjid, because of the barakah of the masjid. Allah is giving you risk.
Hey, sahabi complain, oh, Nabi of Allah, I'm working, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. My brother comes and he sits in your majlis, he spends time with you. I'm doing all the work. Nabi alayhi salam brought it to his notice that possibly you are getting risk because of him. Not he is getting risk because of you. You think so, you're working, you're doing all the work. But zahir, the eyes are telling us, and we need to belie what we are seeing. We need to negate what we are seeing. And we need to establish everything is from Allah. All control belongs to Allah. Maulana Yusuf used to say that the sickness of this ummah is speaking about the creation. That money can do, businesses can do, governments can do, this can do. He said the only cure for this is to speak about Allah. So lesson number two, that the tongue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, we need to speak more about Allah. We need to speak more about the greatness of Allah. When we read Salatul Hajjah, then somebody reads a Salat for the Hajjah. Somebody has a problem, we are told read Salatul Hajjah. It is a Salah of need. And after that, there is a Masnoon Dua to read as well. So ask Allah. But that person who is parishan, in distress, who is perplexed and worried and anxiety, even in his salat, it is reading, he's thinking about it. Oh, I'm going to solve it. I'm going to solve it. How am I going to solve this problem? Ulama say, Salatul Hajjah is a gift. We should read such a salah with such dhyan, such concentration, such khushu, such tawajjuh. Give so much attention. Read such a perfect salah that when you are going to a great king to ask him for a favor, you will give him the appropriate gift. You will be so elated, you will be so happy with your salah that even before you left your hands, even before you left your hands, your hajjah will be fulfilled. One alim, after reading salah, there was a traveler. So the traveler seen the imam, very simple person. And in those days, there was no real structure in place. So he said, I can see maybe you are struggling. Min ayna ta'kul? So the imam said, you repeat your salah. Then I will answer your question. Because risk is from Allah, and we're always looking for an excuse. We meet somebody, we ask him a question, what's your occupation, how do you survive? No, Allah provides. No, but you must be doing something. No, alhamdulillah, Allah has made intizam for me, there is something Allah. No. There'll be question upon question upon question until we don't get a satisfying answer. Then he says, I'm a street sweeper. We'll say, okay, alhamdulillah, now I understand. Where is your sustenance? Where your risk is coming from? A father is traveling with his children in a car. They come to an intersection. There's a man in the middle of the road making signs. And the children start laughing. Is there a clown on the road? What is he doing? Making signs, he's doing that. So they start laughing. So the whole world will laugh at him. He's making signs. But takbir e tahrima, when we make the sign Allahu Akbar, we don't have the yaqeen that my Allah will sustain me. To get this yaqeen, to get this tawakkul and trust in Allah, we need to speak about Allah. Speak so much about Allah. Tell your heart, Allah does. Rizq is from Allah. Shifa is from Allah. Benefit is from Allah. Harm is from Allah. All good is from Allah. Innama amruhu idha arada shay'an ay yaqul lahu kun fayakun. When my Allah wants, it happens. Thus yaqeen we need to make effort on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.